Welcome to the Nanjing International Expo Center. We're in Hall D, and this is the venue for boxing. The night session about to begin, and we will have men's action in the boxing in a number of different weight divisions through to the super heavyweights. And there is the program ahead. These are all preliminary rounds, starting with the men's light flyweight, the under 49 kilogram weight, then the bantamweight, light welterweight, middleweight, heavyweight, and the super heavyweights over 91 kilograms in the preliminary rounds. But that's all ahead of us. Two bouts in each weight division. There are six boxers in each weight category. Two have a bye in the first preliminary round, and four fight. And of course, the winners will go through to what is effectively semi-finals. But in so many weight divisions, 10 weight divisions in all for the men and three weight categories for the women, that's a lot of boxers taking part nevertheless in the Youth Olympic Games. And we're looking forward to the night session. After the first session provided some very good boxing, very competitive matches in both men's and women's competition. Men's bouts over 3 minutes, three rounds, and women's bouts over 2 minutes each, but four rounds. So four rounds of two for the women and three by three for the men, with a minute in between, of course. The scoring system has been very interesting. The judges are using the 10-point must system, where five judges are selected for a bout, but then only three actually take part in the scoring. They're randomly selected, those three out of the five, and only the scores of these three judges count. And at the end of each round, each judge must determine the winning boxer of that round by awarding a score of 10 points and by awarding 9 or less points down to 6 for the loser.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the referee and judges for men's boxing 49 kilograms.
The first bout on the program is the men's light flyweight bout for under 49 kilograms with Shyam Kumar Kakara in the red corner, and Rupert Isianov in the blue corner. And here come the boxers, making their way out now to the ring. Representing India, we have Shyam Kumar Kakara in the red, and Rufat Isianov for Azerbaijan in the blue. This is the lightest of the men's weight divisions, the 46 to 49 kilogram division. The light flyweight. Now these are the smallest of the men, usually also the quickest. Whether or not they actually have in their armory a knockout punch remains to be seen, but you can expect them to be jabbing and moving and very evasive. The scores in some of the bouts have been very close, and the judges must have an opinion who is the winner of the bout in case that is required. Where the scores are level or two judges are equal, The bell for round one of this men's light flyweight preliminary. It's bout number 15 on the program. And from India, in the red and already in trouble, taking a couple of heavy blows. Rufat Feyzniyov from Azerbaijan immediately on target. He's in the blue. And for India, it's Shyam Kumar Kakara fighting back strongly now, but rocked early on. Left jab poised for Kusyanov. Big right cross over the top from the Indian. And settling into the contest now. Oh, they're really throwing them some fairly wild blows, but if one lands, it's going to be a knockdown. Big looping punches from both over the top. Kumar showing a liking for the left hook. Has been falling short of its range so far. Kusyanov moving in within range of those looping left hooks, but no damage done. Right, a rip there from Kakara, trying to come underneath, following through his left jab. The boxer's arms absolutely flailing in this first couple of minutes of the first round. The lead's missing. Kakara there falling backwards as he let go with the big left hook. Just a brushed air across the face of his opponent. Plenty of encouragement from the corners. Good left-right combination from Kusyanov. Kakara coming back with one of his own combinations. Jabs with the left. Tries the right hook. Hard to find the target with these two very quick men. Not through lack of trying. And Kakara pulls the punch as the bell sounds for the end of the first round. And these two light flyweight men not disappointing. Those punches missing the target. 20 being thrown. There must have been a dozen punches there. I don't know that any of them scored. That did, though. That was a great left jab from Kakara. How did the judges see the first round? Well, they are split. Judge A going for Kakara, the Indian in the red. But Judge B and C have Kusyanov ahead. And of course, they are judging on scoring punches, hitting the target area with the central portion of the glove. So both men right in this contest as we go into round two, and they pick up where they left off with a flurry of punches. Both showing good poise, good movement. Oh, lovely left jab fired through from Kusyanov, right to the face. That whistle past the gloves. And a right hook, I think, might have found the target as well from Kusyanov. Roundhouse punches from the man in blue. Cross. And as Huzianov dropping his head down, he came in, he was asking for trouble, and Kakara went for the uppercut but missed. Second time, Rufat Huzianov is told, keep your head up. Jabs away to the left. Kakara waiting for his mark. Doesn't take long for him to try and counter, if not hit first. They meet each other as they both lunge with the punch. Kakara landing a little taller and a slightly longer reach, but not too much in it. And Rufat Huzianov, oh, good combination there from Kakara, but he was off balance and almost hit off his feet by Huzianov, who couldn't quite make it land as his opponent rushed past him. They stand in centre ring. Size up. Kakara gloves high. Huzianov tries to catch him. Napping. Ambushes him quickly. Kakara wanted to go for the uppercut. Pulled it. They lean on each other and now Kakara wants to get on with it. Finding the mark, pulled that off him, right over the top, doubled up by Kakara. And again, he just glanced off the head and then gives him a little clip as the bell goes. Another very competitive round between these two. The advantage held through round one by Rufat Huzianov of Azerbaijan in the blue. In round two, we'll wait for the judge's reckoning. That was a beautiful jab fired through early in the round. That was so quick. Almost no counter to that. If you haven't got your gloves up, you're not going to be able to stop that. A couple of big hooks that didn't quite find their mark. And the judges again disagreeing in the second round. Judge A and B going for Kakara this time, but the Judge C sticks with Huzianov. He has Huzianov 20-18, but the other judges have it all equal. Judge A and B all equal as we go into the third round. Judge C favoring the man in blue. Huzianov with that slight advantage in the judges' minds at this point. And not only in their minds, on the scorecard. Nothing's changed in the tactics. They have their game plan and that is what they're following. Hit and be hit. Kara pegs him right on the nose with a great jab, a left jab. There's a little caution though for pulling him down after that. Neither showing any signs of tiring. Very much an even match for each other. A little feint from Kakara. Got that jab through beautifully a little while back. Goes for the left hook. Huzianov, left-right combination. The right landed. Right cross, favoured by Kakara. Keeps drilling it just over the shoulder, but not always quite on the target. Both very willing as we go into the last minute. Plenty of energy left in the arms. That muscle definition in the back of Rifat Husseinov. And for that matter, his opponent, not carrying an inch of fat. Trying to the minute to peak here. Husseinov attacks with the left. Got a couple of left hands through. This has got to be close. This last 25 seconds could count big time. Picaro with just a little more to do in this round. If he is going to win it. Oh, it comes back with a beautiful right. Both men landing punches, but Kakara's was the best. And that is the end of the fight. And what a good fight it was between these two men's light flyweights. The 46 to 49 kilograms of power punching. And well, it's up to the judges. Very tight contest. Rifat Husseinov in the blue from Azerbaijan. Just leading on the judges' scorecards at the end of the second round. Kakara did plenty in the third round, but Husseinov was sticking with him all the way. Jayam Kumar Kakara from India in the red. He will still be hopeful. Husseinov indicating he's confident of the victory. Here we go.
We home court by speed division. The winner in blue representing Azerbaijan.
And Rifat Husseinov gets the decision, split decision. Kakara very disappointed to put so much effort into three rounds and come away the loser. Winner on points. Two judges to one, split decision. The last round, again a split verdict from the judges. Judge A and Judge C giving it to Kakara. In fact, so two of the judges favoured Kakara in the last round. But the judge from Korea, Judge B, stuck with Husseinov, and there's the final tallies for the judges. Judge A, 30 to 27 to Kakara. Judge C, 28-29, the way of Husseinov. Judge B, he favored Husseinov as well, 29-28. It was close. Kakara stabbed that jab right into the face of Husseinov to give him a flying start to the third round. Left hook clubbing around from Husseinov. And we got the verdict of a very disappointed Indian competitor, but a good win for the man from Azerbaijan. Here we go in the men's light flyweight preliminary round with Mert Karakilic from Turkey to meet Ashalkar Aykınbey from Kazakhstan. The boxer from Kazakhstan in the blue. In the red, Mert Karakilic. All of these athletes are aged from 17 to 18, to be that age, 17 to 18, on December 31st in the year of competition. So for these games, that's between January the 1st of 1996 and December 31st of 1997. That's when they have to be born, 17 or 18. Some of the Youth Olympic Games competitors have been aged as low as 14, 15 and 16. They have to turn a minimum of 15. But in the boxing, the older age groups chosen. A selection of athletes from around the world six athletes in each category. Not every country can send athletes to every sport at the Youth Olympic Games. There is a cap on the numbers. Referee for this bout is Frank Fiaccio from Canada. So away we go with Mert Karacilic from Turkey in the red corner, and in the blue it's Shalka Aykönhierbay, and who is from Kazakhstan. Immediately Aykönhierbay with that left jab, leading his prowess, showing off his prowess with that left jab. Karacilic just a little taller, and with the slightly longer limbs to give him that extra centimetre or two reach. Not a great deal in it, just a touch. Enough to be an advantage if used well. Karacilic nearly throwing himself off his feet as he missed with the looping right hook. And again he went for it and missed for a second time and opened himself up to the counter-attack from Aykönhierbay. Left jab was a good one from the man in blue. Right cross. Shows the variety. Got a few punches. Aykönhierbay moving nicely to make Karacilic miss. Very confident movements from Aykönhierbay so far. Shalka Aykönhierbay in blue from Kazakhstan. Karacilic just seems a little more tentative. He's trying to work out his opponent, work out what punches to throw and where the danger lies. Bobbing and moving left, moving right, down and up. A man from Turkey. ...30 seconds left in this first round of 3 minutes. Three rounds altogether. Intense concentration on the face of Karacilic. He's just a little worried by the punching power of this pocket dynamite Aykönhierbay. The end of the first round. Mert Karacilic of Turkey in the red, and Shalka Aykönhierbay from Kazakhstan in that blue corner, sitting down, being fanned with the towel to cool down. All the old methods still used: sprinkle of the water, fan with the towel. The right cross from Aykönhierbay might have just missed. It looked dangerous. Right cross glancing across the face as well, trading left hooks. The judges are split on the first round, two of them giving it to Aykönhierbay, one to Karacilic. Judge B favouring Karacilic in that first round, Aykönhierbay taking the Well, it's not a points decision, it's just a little stepping stone. Two judges to one in the first round. The can see the judges at the side of the ring, and there are judges on all sides, and they have a variety of angles to view the fight from, and so they can see different aspects of the fight and may not see exactly the same things. One puncher might have his back to them, the other facing them as they see a punch thrown. It's very difficult to see every punch that's thrown. They're so quick when both boxers mix it up. By stepping forward, can't get within range though. Cilic just picking his mark, keeping him at bay. Then there's that movement. He's a little like a praying mantis, the way he bobs forward and back. Then he'll go left and right, but that up and down movement. Keeps away from the corner there, Cilic. The aggressive Eichenbay is after him though. He's after him all right. Eichenbay just assessing whether there is much sting in those punches of Karacilic or not, whether he can afford to try and break his way past them and go really on a full frontal assault. Karacilic just keep poking that jab out and keeping the smaller man at bay. For all of the intent and Eichenbay, he's not landing that many punches, and Karacilic, when he selects his moment, is equal to him. Oh, right was a good one. Good strong punch from Eichenbay. Right cross. Chant goes up in the crowd. Good right counter there from Karacilic. Coming to the end of the second round. Body shot from Eichenbay. And they slap gloves as they walk back to their corners after another stirring round, the second of this men's light flyweight competition. By continuing to be the aggressor and to take the fight to his opponent, but Karacilic up to the mark most of the time. Both those punches missing. This is what you can see in slow motion. It's hard to catch with live action. So many punches being slipped, and judges all favouring Eichenbay in that second round. Schalke Eichenbay scoring 10-9 in every one of those judges' cards for the second round, so he is narrowly ahead. Two of the judges have Eichenbay up 20-18. The other judge has it equal at 19 each. So Eichenbay with the advantage going into the third round. Karacilic still in with a chance if he's good enough. I've described him as being a little like a praying mantis in his evasive movements. His general demeanor as he faces his opponent. Well, let's see if he is like a praying mantis and ready to strike at just the right moment. Still striving to get just that little bit closer. Those punches just missing short. So did Eichenbay's right hand. Cilic on the mark a little closer that time. It's all about the gloves. It's the eyes that tell the story. Such intense concentration on exactly where their opponent is. A big go. Right hand over the top. Stop. man in blue. Plenty of movement from him too. He is never in the same place for more than a millisecond. He's always moving forward, back, a little to the side. So we're coming to the final minute, and this is a gripping contest between Mert Karacilic of Turkey in the red and Shalka Akinbay of Kazakhstan in the blue. Very tight contest. Akinbay, narrow leader through the first two rounds. The judges not always in agreement. Both with plenty of sting left in their arms. Plenty of power to deliver. Oh, the right hand, I think, was a scoring punch from Akinbay. It found its mark. Karacilic throws himself forward. Another right hand to the side of the head from Akinbay. They're warming to their task now, and the crowd roaring. 20 seconds to go. Karacilic with a left-right combination. Akinbay ducks in, ducks away again, gets out of trouble. And there is the bell, which brings an end to this bout after three good rounds of boxing in the men's light flyweight division. The question is, did Shalka Akinbay do enough in that last round to hold on to his lead, possibly even extend it? Mert Karacilic threw some good punches at him. The man from Turkey in blue, from Kazakhstan, I should say the man from Turkey in red, blue is from Kazakhstan. These young men, their boxing career ahead of them, a chance to be a youth Olympic champion if they can go through from the preliminaries. And in the blue corner, a unanimous decision, and well, Mert Karacilic not really willing to accept the decision, was reluctant to congratulate his opponent, but then the sportsmanship has shone through. Shalka Akinbay from Kazakhstan is the winner. Unanimous decision on points. There's the final tally. 30-27 to Akinbay from Judge A. 29-28 from Judge C to Akinbay. And Judge B, 29-28 to Akinbay. Though the judges were split on that third round as well, so they certainly weren't always in agreement as to who was the better boxer. It was that kind of a contest, contrasting styles and moments of effectiveness, but you'd have to say that Shalka Akinbay was the aggressor more often, and just managing to land a good effective punches like that right-left combination, the left hook, among the punches that earned him victory. Up one division, the men's bantamweight competition preliminary rounds for the under 56 kilograms. Michael Takac from Slovakia in the red will meet Peter McGrail from Great Britain in the blue. Here come the boxers, led out by the man in red, Michael Takac. Showing that nervous energy. Michael Takac from Slovakia. A young man with a relatively young coach there assisting him. Peter McGrail from Great Britain wraps on the blue head guard. From Turkey, from Russian Federation. These Youth Olympic bouts coming under the auspices of AIBA, with the scoring system being applied, the 10-point must system. 10 points awarded to the winner of each round, and then the loser will be awarded 9 points or down to 6 points for a poorer performance. And then they're tallied up over the three rounds, three judges giving those 10 must scores. A referee from Denmark, Klaus Biedermann.
Round one.
Round one underway. Bouncing around, showing good early movement in the red, Michael Takacs from Slovakia. Stepping up early, Peter McGrail in the blue from Great Britain. Leading with his right hand, southpaw. And a flurry of punches unloaded by Takacs. Good left hand landing for McGrail from Britain. McGrail looks to have that straight left hand popped, ready to fire it. Just to follow up the right lead with the left, and the left will be the damaging punch. He might have just landed that one too as he is shooting up towards the chin. Just a push down. Takacs hanging out that left-hand lead. Left-right combinations from Takacs. Good movement from both men, aiding their defense. And the man from Slovakia comes in with arms wailing. Punches are very quick. But the man in blue having the better of it, I feel, Peter McGrail from Great Britain. Seems to have more effective punching power so far. From Slovakia, just a little more open in his stance on the end of the first round. McGrail, lots of nervous energy there as he seated down on the stool. And the judges are split on how they saw the first round. Haven't been able to agree on who was on top. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of that first 3 minutes. Left hook from Takacs, landed without real power, but landed. Short right from Takacs slipping through as well. Judge A has given the round to Michael Takacs, but judges B and C to Peter McGrail of Great Britain, the man in blue. At this stage, the judges are only identified as A, B and C, but after the fight, We are told who the judges represent or which countries they come from. We have five judges who could be amongst those three chosen. Someone from Russia, Turkey, Chinese Taipei, Bulgaria and Kazakhstan are all seated by the ringside right now. But only three of them will be the ones chosen to give their scores. Heavy exchange. The Slovakian, somewhat the taller of the two, a little rangier. There's always going to be one boxer, or almost always going to be one boxer. Oh, that looked like a collected. Who's going to be slightly disadvantaged when it comes to reach. Working to the right hand. And both missing on this occasion. Oh, the left was a good one. From McGrail, just rocked Takac for a moment, straightened him up. The lead from Takac is not causing McGrail any worry. He's prepared to walk through it and fire that left hand back in retaliation. Good right hand there from Takac, though. He did get it through the guard. He's a busy fighter, Peter McGrail, a man in blue from Britain. Takac landing with the left, hesitating. Last few seconds of the second round. McGrail with the guard up high, protecting against the jab of Takac. Takac sits down on the stool and water sprinkled on the biceps, which is now starting to burn with the lactic acid. McGrail reasonably composed. Let's see how heavy those punches were that landed. There was a left hand stuck in the face, and that's a straight left also making contact with the face. Pretty heavy exchanges. Takac's got the right through there. And it's that left hand that carries the detonator from Peter McGrail. Well, still judges B and C. Sticking with Peter McGrail, 10-9 again, but the Judge A sees it the other way. So Judge A is impressed by the performance of Michael Takac and has been in both rounds, 10-9. The other two judges both rule 10-9 in favour of Peter McGrail. If it continues, McGrail's going to win this, but let's see if Michael Takac can impress the other judges as well in this round. Just holding up that left lead, not even pouring with it really, it's just there as a protection mechanism. McGrail coming in with combinations. Diving in with the left hand, feints one way, heads to the right, ducks under it and comes out to the left. Okay. Still plenty of energy in the legs. Takes one to the body. Big left sailed through the air from McGrail. Well over the head. McGrail launching in with the uppercut, but missed by some distance. Combination of punches there from Takacs. Lunging combination as well from McGrail. This isn't over yet as we come towards the final minute. Takacs is still going strong, but he's certainly getting more than he asks for from McGrail. McGrail looks like he's got the endurance to go the full 3 minutes here in the final round. Takacs is still moving well. In blue now, Peter McGrail, or both in fact being spoken to for holding. Takacs. Launching with the right arm. Can't get that hand to contact though. Last few seconds. Takacs needs to finish strongly, but it's McGrail who lets fly with a flurry to the head. And one on the bell from Takacs. So the end of the third round, the third and final round. Peter McGrail of Great Britain. Having a points lead with two judges through the first two rounds. Might have done enough in that third round to keep Michael Takacs at bay. Takacs are trying hard. He didn't quite have the power that McGrail had, but was picking off the jab occasionally. How close has this bout proven to be in the end? Here comes the judges' decisions. Peter McGrail from Great Britain in the blue corner takes the victory. Winner on points, a split decision. And even Judge C awarding the final round to Peter McGrail. I should say to Michael Takacs, but in fact Judge B went the other way in the final round. And there's the tally, 30-27 from Judge A for Takacs. But for McGrail, 30-27 and 29-28 from Judges B and C, who happen to be from Bulgaria and Kazakhstan, by the judge from Chinese Taipei. Right hook from McGrail into the face. Straight right on the counter, moving away from Takacs, didn't carry much weight. A couple of good blows in that flurry from McGrail. The left on the mark. Takacs fighting back. That was right on the bell. And Peter McGrail, the winner from Great Britain. On a decision that in the end, well, the two judges went his way. This is a preliminary in the men's bantamweight competition for under 56 kilograms. Cuba versus Tunisia, red versus blue, Javier Ibanez Diaz versus Mekki Ben Said. Said from Tunisia will be in the blue corner. Two boxers parading out in Hall D of the Nanjing International Expo Center. In the red, Javier Ibanez Diaz from Cuba. Climbing through the ropes in the blue corner from Tunisia, Mekki Ben Said. From the Republic of Korea, Nakchun Bayit.
From People's Republic of China.
Not in.
From Poland.
They touch gloves. Last instructions from the referee.
In.
Get the helmet out of it, and also no low blows. Away we go for the first round of this bantamweight contest. Javier Ibanez Diaz from Cuba in the red, and Mekki Ben Said from Tunisia in the blue. Tunisian leading with the right hand, and the Cuban with the left hand lead. And the man in red trying to tag his opponent early. Said trying to blast through the guard, the gloves up in front of the face of Ibanez Diaz. Serious exchange, flurry of punches. Ben Said again blasting away, but all taken on the gloves by Ibanez Diaz. Ben Said got himself caught near the ropes there, a little off balance as he retreated. Half a dozen punches thrown by both. Said becoming more aggressive now. He's got a fair bit of time on his bike, but when he wants to, he'll stand and deliver. Even as Diaz clubbing away at the head. Another volley of punches high on the chest from Ibanez Diaz. Oh, it was a good right hand there to end the round from Ben Said. He was moving backwards, but threw out the right hand. It may not have had as much power on it as he would have liked, but nevertheless, it found its target. A couple of body shots here from Ibanez Diaz in the red. Left and right pumping out. Smuck the right through past the guard there. And sent Ben Said reeling backwards and away, trying to get out of trouble. The judges like the work of Ibanez Diaz in the red. All of them agreeing it was a 10-9 point decision in the first round. Round two. And Ben Said really just throwing punches at the gloves there. Even as Diaz means business. On the break there, as they moved away from each other, from Ben Said. Left-right combinations, a variety of work from Ibanez Diaz. And again, left jab nearly got through as well. Ben Said not moving as much at the moment. He comes in and rips away at the body. Even as Diaz also going for a body shot or two. Both starting to stand a little more now. Not as quick around the ring, even as Diaz, who was using the full circle of the ring before. He was circling inside the square. Now he's just a little more stationary. Rips forward there, though. Sudden movement forward and fired that straight left hand. The last minute of the 3 minute second round. Left right from Ben Said. Needs to win this round to get back to level pegging. Ben Said firing punches, but the gloves covering up from Ibanez Diaz. A little bit of tape has fallen away from one of the boxer's equipment. Actually, it might have been the mouthguard, was it? It was the mouthguard. Well, the mouthguard back in for Ben Said with 9 seconds remaining. And look at the body shots from Ibanez Diaz. Really working hard on that abdomen and taking some of the wind out of the sails of Ben Said, who's told to stand up. But that's the end of the round. Okay, a pretty good round for Ibanez Diaz. Speed seemed to go out of Ben Said. His body shot might have been just slowing him down. And, even as Diaz continuing to pick off with volleys of punches, pick off his target. Right hand got through there and landed. Well, quite a few of those punches going over the top. But, the judges continue to be impressed by Javier Ibanez Diaz. He wins the second round as well. 10-9, 10-9, 10-9. All three judges agreeing, so he's won both rounds. Unanimously, 10-9. The question is, has Mickey Ben Said of Tunisia in the blue, has he got reserves of strength and endurance to keep on going here now? There's no let up at this stage from Michael, from Javier Ibanez Diaz. Of course, he might. It doesn't look like it at this point, but he could punch himself out as well. He's thrown plenty, probably more than his opponent. Fitness all important in boxing, as is technique and mental fortitude. Throwing punches from some distance away there, Ben Said. Both missed. Even as Diaz thunders a few off the gloves, couldn't get them through. What you see is what you get from Even as Diaz. That's if you do see it. Just keeps firing those punches straight from the shoulder. He's got good variety. Looping right to the body. What's Ben Said got left now? A minute 30 left in the bout. Not too much strength on those punches as they just bounced off the gloves. Left-right combination, but it lacked sting. A little more in the arms on those on that occasion. Minute of the fight. Ben Said launches in with another volley of punches aimed at the body. Even as Diaz seems to be riding out the storm. Not a moment's peace from Even as Diaz for Ben Said. The man in red doing enough at this stage. Even as Diaz still confident of his ability to dominate here. He continues to stalk his opponent. Ben Said needs one big punch. Might be too late now. Even as Diaz. The man in red finishes strongly enough against Mickey Ben Said of Tunisia, the man in blue. Not too convinced that he did enough in that third round to overturn the disadvantage as he fell behind in the first two rounds, according to the judges. And Javier Ibanez Diaz looks pretty composed. Barely raised a sweat. Look at him. Just a little bit of a sweat on him, but certainly no drops pouring from the face. He's barely out of breath. He's very composed, Javier Ibanez Diaz, despite three-minute rounds.
We call point by unanimous decision. The winner is Red Corner, representing Cuba.
Javier Ibanez Diaz from Cuba. A convincing victory on points. Unanimous decision from the judges. They scored every round of that fight 10-9. All three judges in total agreement. And the tally 30-27 from all three judges. A good win, very convincing. Javier Ibanez Diaz from Cuba goes through to the next phase of competition. some of the best young boxers in the world in the Youth Olympic Games, and this is a men's light welterweight competition, under 64 kilograms, preliminary match. From Hungary, Richard Toth in the red, and from Turkey, Adem Furkan Avci in the blue. Boxers have been warming up outside. Now they're ready for the real thing, the thing that matters. The referee is Dini Kuradina from Sri Lanka. An international panel of judges for this fight from Canada, Great Britain, Kazakhstan, Tunisia and Russia. Three of those five judges will be scoring this fight. And the bell is ready to ring. The Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games bell. Round one of this men's light welterweight competition match. Richard Toth of Hungary in the red and Adem Furkan Avci of Turkey in the blue. Supremely fit. Avci in the blue with a very sturdy build. Good movement though from Richard Toth. He'll need to move well though. Avci full of punching power here and real intent. Standing tall and firing from that left shoulder with the jab. Up clean with the left jab. Jab, jab, jab with the left again, and then he follows it up with a right hand hook. Left hook to the side of the head. In comes Avci again with a combination of punches. Some real punching power behind Avci's work here. Getting a bit torrid for Richard Toth at the moment. He's in the corner and Avci's all over him. Big wild hook from Richard Toth trying to fight his way out of trouble. And he knows this is not going to be a walk in the park. Richard Toth very aggressive. Ardem Furkan Avci from Turkey. He's given plenty of encouragement by his coach. And both landing left hooks there. But towards the end of the first round that Avci really got on top. Backpedaling rapidly there, Top was in trouble. Not really hit with anything that hurt too much. He knew that he needed to get out of there, and the judges liked the performance of Avci in that first round. Giving him the nod, 10-9. Richard Top cops a barrage. Whatever his coach said to him in the break between rounds, he needs to put into practice, because at the moment Avci starting to get more and more on top. Jab, jab, left jab from Richard Top. In the corner, bounces off the turnbuckle. You want to get caught there, and he'll be a punching bag. The center of the ring. Top stalks, so backing away as Avci stalks his man. Avci fires out the right. More and more, Top's movement is backwards. Even though he's the man with the long reach. Mind you, sometimes the boxer with the reach will stay on the back pedal, because he can use that reach to counter punch. Had the feeling early on here that Top was prepared to fire out the jab, but Avci is wearing him down. Hangs on for a moment there. Avci, left jab. Couple of short lefts there from the top. Top was standing his ground for all that Avci was strong in the early stages of the fight. Ring close to the action here. Last few seconds of the second round. Top making a fair fist of the fight through the last minute and a half of that fight. He was able to stand and meet Avci. Ardem Furkan Avci from Turkey in the blue. Richard Top from Hungary in the red. See some of these second round highlights. There's Avci. Finally got that right hand to stick in the face. Just with some of the earlier punches. Rips to the body. Top with a left hook. Good evasion there to stay out of trouble. And the judges are split on this second round. Richard Top earning the approval of Judge A and Judge C. So we've got a real good battle on our hands here in the judges' opinion. In fact, Judge A and C have got it all level. Judge B, though, in favour of Avci. 20-18 in his opinion. 19 each from the other judges. Nem vagyok egy picit békén. Upke steps it up as he starts the third round. Adam Furkan Upke of Turkey in the blue, Richard Tok of Hungary in the red. And Tok, he's on the retreat there, back into the corner. And again, circling the ring. Plenty of encouragement coming from the Hungarian corner from the coach. Instructions and encouragement. Upke stalking his man. Tok waiting, ready to react. Nice little right hand over the top from Upke. Don't know that it really landed. Upke missing right over the top with the big right hook. The Hungarian coach calling on Richard Tok to step up. Right left combination from Tok. Upke tags him with the left. With a left from Upke again. Now they're getting stuck into it. Into the final minute. Upke will not take a backward step. Tok trying to find something. Upke's got him in a headlock. Referee says to Tok, keep your head up and you won't get into a headlock. Both these boxers are game. Upke knows nothing but stepping forward, throwing punches. Tok realizes that's the way he has to go if he's going to win this fight. Tok with a body rip. Upke, flinging right hand, flies over the top. Body shot, comes out of it. Still strong with the left hand too, Upke. Last few seconds, toe to toe. They both swing hard. And they've both given it everything they had. Richard Tok gets the nod from his coach. He's in with a chance. Adam Furkan Upke from Turkey has punched himself right out. He gave it everything that he had in those arms. And his coach congratulates him on a big effort. Might have done enough there, Upke, through the early stages of the fight, but Tok needs congratulations as well because he came back hard. Has he come back hard enough? Adam Furkan Upke, winner on point in a unanimous decision from the judges. He is the winner of this preliminary bout. Continue through to effectively is the semi-finals. The final scores very close, 29-28 from each of the judges, but all three of them going for Upke of Turkey and handing him the victory. Well earned. One of the highlights is Richard Tok backing into the corner. Very determined boxer in blue. Adam Furkan Upke would not give up the hunt. Stalked his opponent. Predicted victory for himself, and he was right. Upke gets the nod from the judges.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the refereeing judges for men boxing 64 kilogram.
青年朋友们，女士们，先生们，让我们欢迎男子拳击64公斤级的场上裁判员入场。A light welterweight contest coming up in the preliminary round for the men under 64 kilogram weight division from Italy, Vincenzo Areccia, and from the Ukraine, Viktor Petrov. Stepping into the ring, wearing the gear equipment, Vincenzo Areccia. Unlike at the Olympic Games, where the two semi-finalists are awarded bronze medals, there will be a bronze medal bout stage at the Youth Olympic Games. That's something to look forward to. The losers of these preliminary rounds have the opportunity to compete for fifth place in the classification. The losers of the semi-final bouts will meet for the bronze medal. The winners of the semi-final bouts will meet for the gold medal. The bell goes for the first round. This men's light welterweight category fight for under 64 kilograms from Italy in the red, Vincenzo Areccia, and from the Ukraine in the blue, Viktor Petrov. Petrov leading with his right hand. Showing that once he decides to throw a punch, it's going to be followed with a combination. He waits, and then he goes. Both of them are. Areccia as well. Just pouring out with that lead hand. Feeling the distance between them. Crowd like that exchange. Particularly from Petrov's point of view. Truly cocked from Areccia. Tough contact in there. Both men having a flurry of punches. You can hear them landing. Hard to see them landing, though. Great combination there in retaliation mode from Viktor Petrov. No doubting the aggression, though, of Vincenzo Areccia. As I said, once he decides to punch, he leaps into action. waiting to pick his moment for spring. Instructions for Vincenzo Aritzia from his coach from Italy. Jab falling just short from left rock. The judges can't agree on it. One judge in favour of Aritzia, two in favour of Petrov. 10-9. And there are the possible scores that can be awarded. And the most often awarded score, 10-9. Using their lead arm almost like fences. Fencing, another aspect of the Youth Olympic Games here in Nanjing. And just feeling their opponent with that lead arm. Petrov beginning these exchanges, initiating the contact, throwing three or four and then dancing away. Aritzia not slow to come back at him in the counter-attack, but by the time the last punch of Aritzia is thrown, Petrov is gone. Aritzia's left hand proving more potent than his right so far. Petrov on his toes. This is not a jabbing contest so far. It's a battle of combinations. They attack, they retreat, they look at each other, attack, retreat. Aritzia stepping in, stepping back out again. An even-handed bout again. First round going narrowly to Petrov. Second round, not too much in it again. Aritzia, they're unleashing. Both are willing to step into each other's territory, but neither able to really take full toll of it. Again, the judges are split here. Judge A and C ruling in favour of Petrov 10-9, but Judge B, he sees it Aritzia 10-9. So Judges B and C have got it all level at 19 each. Judge A has a Petrov ahead, 20-18. Oh! this is the third and final round. Men's light welterweight division. Viktor Petrov in the blue from the Ukraine has a narrow lead, courtesy of one judge. Vincenzo Archer of red has shown that he can meet Petrov and go with him through many of the exchanges. Petrov just punching a little the cleaner and a little more often, landing on target. Italian in the red. Now he lifts that left arm up. Seems to be dropping it. And lifts it up to some style. Arachia can win this fight. And if he can win this round, Arachia looking strong, but so too is Petrov, neither weakening in his final minute now. Both have plenty left in the tank. Just a question of technique and reactions now. Continuing pattern, this flurry of exchanges. Not too many of those punches landing. More missing. But if one can hit home, it can be the difference. Archer comes in, arms flailing. Just out of range. Now Archer steps in, trying to finish it strong. Petrov responds to the challenge. Petrov walks away. The Italian thinks that he might have done enough. Petrov, unperturbed. It'll be interesting to see whether or not Arachia can get the majority verdict in that third round. If so, he might be able to just edge ahead on points. There was no sign of Viktor Petrov weakening at any stage. The Italian believing that he might be able to get the decision. He's in the red, pumping up the right arm.
Point by split division. The winner is Brad Corner, representing Italy.
And it is Vincenzo Arachia who gets the verdict. The Italian, a winner on points, 2-1. It'll be very interesting to see the breakdown of the points in that third round. And in fact, it was Arachia 10-9 in each of the judges' opinions in the third round, and so therefore he went over the top. Arachia 29-28 in the decision of Judge B and C. Petrov taking 29-28 from Judge A, but 2-1 the decision goes to Vincenzo Arachia from Italy, came from behind to win that preliminary bout of the men's light welter. Let's take a look at some of the punches from Viktor Arachia and see how many of them scored in these highlights, because the judges were sufficiently impressed, all ruled in his favor in the third and final round. Just enough to steal the victory away from the gallant Viktor Petrov. Arms raised for the Italian.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the Brazilian judges for men boxing 75 kilograms.
Up a division into the men's middleweights, under 75 kilogram bout in the preliminary rounds. From Finland, Kale Kalinin, and from Uzbekistan, Kuzimbek Mardanov. crowd breaks into a chant. Kalle Kalenionon from Finland in the red. From Uzbekistan, Kozimbek Madonov. Bodies pumping with nervous energy, these two boxers. Young men with a limited experience on the international stage. I can only imagine the adrenaline must be pumping through their body. Given the chance at a Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing 2014. Representing their countries, their families, and themselves. Coaches, of course, all the people who put work into their career at this young age. A chance for a Youth Olympic medal. This is only the preliminary stage, of course. They can win here in this bout. They continue their campaign and remain in contention for a medal. The bell for round one. Men's middleweight contest with under 75 kilograms. Kalle Kalenionon from Finland and Kozimbek Madonov from Uzbekistan. The Uzbek in the blue, the Finn in the red. From Madonov. Thunders the left hand into the body. Kalenionon. Has to slip. Kalenionon with quite a wide stance. Movement of the body, I mean, rather than the gloves. Good attack from Madonov. Acting close. Right cross is a good one from the Finn, but he got a punch back from Madonov for his trouble. So, big left, both missing from Madonov. Too much damage done by either fighter. There's no doubting the potency of the attack. His muscles are primed to deliver. Both are ready to do it. trying to find the target off the trick. The right hook from Martinov. And a nice, great right jab through the defences from Martinov as well. Look at it from a different angle. Judges liking the attack of Martinov there. More aggressive and more effective. 10-9 from all three judges for round one. Round two, and away we go. Oh, looked like to me, Kalianon walked straight into a punch there, right on the nose. Got the hands down, he's not got the guard up. Big left, flies over the top from Martinov. Leonin is picking off a combination. These are bigger men. You don't expect them to be moving as quickly. But nevertheless, there seems to be a little more mobility in Martinov than Kalianin. Kalianin tending to balance back and forth in a straight line rather than having that sideways dimension to his evasiveness and unpredictability. Right lead from Martinov. Punches in with the straight left though. And Kalianin fighting back. Body shot from Martinov. Leonin feinting to throw the punch. Drew Martinov out. Good right hander from Martinov. Came over the top. Martinov. Right left combination as he lurched towards the fin. Big punch on board if he can get to use it. Martinov, though, throwing plenty of punches. Really favoring that straight left.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
Last seconds of the second round. Leonin taking the fight to his opponent, but Martinov countering. End of the second round as both march back to their corner. Martinov still just in charge, you would think, to some extent. Leonin on the counter-attack, but unable to land too many big blows or too many scoring punches. Martinov with that big right hand there, booming into the face of Kalianin. Gets another right hand in there to score as well. And the judges are all in favour of Martinov at the moment. Bozenbek Martinov winning every round of the fight in the judges. Well, there's only been two rounds, but the three judges and six verdicts, if you like, on the two rounds, all in favour of Martinov, 10-9. So what can Kalle Kalianon from Finland do here? He's the man in red. He's trailing. Kozimbek Martinov of Uzbekistan in the blue. more scoring punches so far. Kalianen still looks capable of going the distance here, and I've got that feeling that he's got a big punch there. If he can just get to use it. This is Mardanov now with a flurry of punches. Mardanov scoring regularly enough. Don't know that he has really rocked Leonin. And just keeps on coming. Mardanov very busy, but it looks as if he has the stamina to keep going all the way as well. These three-minute rounds. Left hand still got plenty of punch in it again from Mardanov. Mardanov lands another scoring punch as he struck the right jab through the defences. Lennon works to the body. Push down. Mardanov is not going to take anything for granted here. Doesn't back Mardanov. And even if he thought he had the better of the first two rounds, he wants to make sure of the victory. He's not going to step back and take any expectations of a win for granted. Doesn't want to take too many risks, though. Fires out that right jab. Pinpoint accuracy. Leonon might be tiring here now. Another right, and a right hook crashes through from Mardanov. Leonon starting to take some punishment now. The Finn fights on. Mardanov happy enough to clinch. Goes after him though as they break apart. Mardanov wants to finish it in style. Left-right combination. And a good finish from Kozimbek Mardanov. And the suggestion is that Kale Kalianen might not have been able to do enough there to worry Mardanov. Coming into the third round with a solid lead from the judges. Gave a brave display nevertheless to Leonin. Hard work went into it. Leonin sucking it in still, sucking that oxygen in. And Kozimbek Mardanov joins him with
the referee. We have won by unanimous decision. The winner is Blue Corner, representing
Kozimbek Mardanov from Uzbekistan, a winner on points unanimously from all the judges, has scored every round 10-9 in his favour. Hard to take the defeat when you put so much in it. Kozimbek Mardanov, 30-27 from all of the judges, and he progresses to the next stage of the competition. Mardanov finished it off in good style. Those are right jabs. Really did some damage in the last round. Slowed up Kalianen into the last minute. There's another. And a right hook. And another right hook. As that short exchange landing multiple punches right on the face of Kalianen. And earning a decisive victory and unanimous victory for Kozimbek Mardanov. Our next bout at the International Expo Centre in Nanjing is a preliminary contest, men's middleweight bout, under 75 kilograms, from Australia, Vitaly Tevi-Fui-Mayono, and from Ukraine, Ramil Gadziev. Men's middleweight contest.
The blue corner representing Ukraine.
Let's go, Ukraine. From the Ukraine, salutes the crowd. In the blue corner. Referee is from Vietnam, Duong Trong Nha. He checks. The man in red from Australia, Vitaly Tevi-Fui-Mayono. Gloves and are ready to do battle boxing style. Sparring away at each other early on here. No mucking around, straight into the action. Big left jab from Gadziev, man in blue from the Ukraine. Considerably taller than the Tevi-Fui-Mayono. In the red. You can make the assumption that if you're in the same weight category and you had to weigh in at the same weight, which in this case is 75 kilograms, and one's taller than the other, well, there must be a weight distribution somewhere else, and the smaller man looks that a little bit stockier. Australian in the red looks that a little bit more robust in build, where Gadziev with the extra height just a little lankier. And you can almost see the difference in trajectory of the punches. Gadziev aiming for the head and possibly you're shooting down just the front of the touch, whereas Tevi-Fui-Mayono, as the mouth guard goes flying, seems to be aiming his punches just up a fraction at the angle. Mind you, Tevi-Fui-Mayono also has the opportunity to go for the body and take the wind out of his opponent with body shots. Good evasion by Tevi-Fui-Mayono. Plenty of courage from both boxers here. Not afraid to step within range but throw a punch. A lot of movement as well in this first round, both fresh. Plenty of wind and energy in the legs. Mayono pumps out the left hand. Left hand body shot from Mayono. Unload with a left and right combination. Tell you, straight left. Puts out the left again, Gadziev. Well, a great first round from these two. not taking a backward step and really ready to mix it. Sucking in the oxygen, understandably, after a fiercely fought first round. Hard to split them. There was the nap guard being lost. You see there, Tevi Fuimaono almost leaping forwards and upwards to target the head of the taller opponent. The judges, well, they couldn't split it either. Very close. 10-9 from Judge A and B in favour of Gadzia from Ukraine. Judge C favouring the Australian. Oh, 10 points to 9 decisions. So a long way to go in this fight as we go into the second round. Gadzia starts as he did the first round, pumping out the left jab. Heavy through Miami. Plenty of power in those biceps of his. Takes a punch as a left hook from Gadzia. Gadzia takes a jab in as he ran past. Out comes the left hook from Tevi Thui Moano. Keeping a distance this time. Both men trying to fire from just a little too far away, falling short. Good left from Tevi Thui Moano. Oh, nice combination from Gadziev. More of a classical boxer. Tevi Thui Moano. Ready to battle it out. Again, those long limbs of Gadziev with the reach. Jabbing and putting together left-right combinations. Thui Moano ready to unleash at any opportunity. Anytime he's within range, he just launches all of his body weight behind the punch. Throws the right over the top, just glanced off the chin. Now back away from each other. Nice left jab from Thui Moano. Fascinating battle of styles this. The more classical Ramu Gadziev in the blues. And the battling Tevi Thui Moano. On the other hand, wants to get in and throw some leather. Not that he's without technique. Flurry on the bell from Gadziev. Moano stopping his guard as the bell went. So a torrid second round. And again, not easy for the judges. Contrasting style. Gadziev is able to pick his opponent off a little more. Got the right hand through there, the short right, but back comes Tevi Moano. It's a straight to the left of his own. Both men landing half-hearted left-handed hooks. Not really delivered with full power. And two of the judges have Garcia ahead, 22-18. Judge C has it all level. Judge C gave the last round. All of the judges gave the last round to Gadziev. begin the third round the way they began the first. No backing off. Stand and deliver. Throwing plenty of heavy punches. Nothing classical about Gadzeev right now. He just wants to get in there and mix it. Heavy Fui Moano. You wouldn't want to meet him in a dark alley. Another good exchange. Gadzeev with his technique. He might be just getting on top. And there's a rock and tumble contest. Satali, Tevi Fui Maeno. Not going to give this away. He is going to keep swinging and swinging hard. He's out punching, but a great counter-attack here from Gadzeev. And an uppercut as well. Just as Tevi Fui Maeno thought that he had landed a couple of good blows, Gadzeev struck back. Nice left jab from Tevi Fui Maeno. Gadzeev still ready to stand and punch it out rather than get on his bike. Misses with a couple, made to miss. Tevi Fui Maeno goes after him, gets him in the corner. Left jab, traded for left jab. All or nothing now. Both men seem to feel that the match is, the bout is in the balance. Left hook from Gadzeev. Maeno keeps on coming. Rips to the body. 20 seconds. Big finish coming up here. I'll be surprised if they don't go hell for leather from here. Tevi Fui Maeno. Everything to gain. Fires out a right, just missed. Left hook misses from Gadzeev. Tevi Fui Maeno, 4 seconds remaining. Stands up, wants to fight on, but the bell's gone. And that was a fight and a half from these two. Both camps claiming victory. Judges A and B favouring Gadzeev, 20 to 18 going into the final round. That C had it all level at 19 each. So it was up to Tevi Fui Maeno from Australia to win the last bout, win the last round if he was going to win the bout. Here comes the decision.
We all fought by unanimous decision. The winner is Blue
Corner. Winner for Man in Blue, Ramu Gadzeev from the Ukraine. A grimace from Satali Tevi Fui Maeno of Australia. Gave it plenty. That's a grimace of disappointment. Gadzeev taking a 30-27 from two judges, and Judge C gave it 29-28 to Ramu Gadzeev of the Ukraine. Good display from Ramu Gadzeev. Showed he had the classical technique, but also he was willing to mix it, and he had to. Had a very tough opponent there. Gadzeev comes out swinging the left hook. There's one particular exchange. Oh, look at that right hook. And the left and right. All three punches landed. It's a Tevi Fui Maeno. Despite that, comes back to launching them himself. Big left. And victory to Ramu Gadzeev in this preliminary round bout. they get bigger and heavier. The men's heavyweight division, the under 91 kilogram weight category, preliminary round bout between for Cuba, Jordan Alain Hernandez Morjon, and from the Ukraine, Robert Marton. Morjon climbing into the ring. Here comes Robert Marton from the Ukraine. Robert Marton from the Ukraine. Under 91 kilogram division fight. Ring the bell and begin the battle. Marton from the Ukraine steps up. Hernandez Morjon fired off a couple of jabs into the air. That's a firecracker. They weren't going to hit. Both men leading with the left. Heavy contact there too. Ooh, this is talking about firecrackers. Good fungus going off here. Marton back into the corner. Almost takes out the cameraman. Cameraman adjusting his glasses. He's okay. He'll continue, as will the boxers. That's what you call getting the lens right in the fight for us and for you. Robert Marton, that's his view. And there's the cameraman in the background on the far corner. Neutral corner. Hernandez Morjon stalking his man. He's the taller opponent. Taller of the two opponents. Robert Marton in the blue. These bigger men, they land a punch flush. It is really going to rock you. There's weight behind it. And remarkably good movement too. There's 91 kilogram men, or just under that. The power of those punches as they are whacked into arms and gloves. Small detonations. Not even getting through to the body though. Not scoring punches. A solid first round from both men. Not a lot in it. Both giving as much as they were taking. It's time to hop, get someone to do that with the crowd. stand in front of you, pour a bit of water on you, and give it a good fling. Early standoff between these two. Left and right crashing into each other, but just missing the target. The judges preferring the work, at least two of the judges, no, all three, giving it to the man from Cuba, Fernandez Morjon, 10-9 from each of the judges. Didn't think there was a lot in it, but the judges are obliged to find a winner in every round, pick a winner. You can't rule it 10-10 or 9-9. They have to give the winner 10 points and the loser 9 down to 6. In general, the judges award point score of 10-9 or 10-8. In 10-7 in any round so far today. Robert Marton stepping up the attack here, coming to go after his opponent. Fernandez Morjon. Good footwork. The Cuban with combinations of punches. Come in. Gloves on the chin, head to head with the head guard in place, right against each other. Not a game to move a muscle, in case that provided the opening for a punch. Fernandez Morjon, quick right as they pushed away from each other. Feinting, move one way or the other, Fernandez Morjon. Marton, he's more straight up and down. Body shots from Fernandez Morjon, cutting away on the stomach area. Big straight rights from both, gliding past the face. Whoa, he's down. He was off balance, and Fernandez Morjon caught him. He was just on the back foot. Certainly a punch that landed. Don't know that it hurt him so much. I think he was off balance, and the punch landing knocked him down. A standing 8 count on Robert Marton. Fernandez Morjon doesn't really go after Marton, so he realizes he's not wounded by that knockdown. Pride might be hurt, but not sustaining any serious damage. Yes, Fernandez Morjon throwing that straight right on the break. And warned by the referee, who breaks cleanly. 10 seconds to go. Marton hasn't changed his pattern, he's still coming forward. The end of that round, Robert Marton to the stool. His legs look steady. To watch the replay of that and also to see the judges scoring of that round. Similar in many ways to the first round except for the knockdown. Straight left from Marton might have been among the better punches there. Here's a good one. And there is the knockdown punch. You can see it was the left hand that did the damage, and Marton was struggling and really just sat down on his bum. The judges, two of the judges are scoring that in favour of Fernandez Morjon 10-9. One judge, Judge B, making that 10-8 in Fernandez Morjon's favour. Robert Marton comes out knowing that he's behind on the scoreboard now. All three judges have him trailing. He needs more than a narrow points victory in this third round. He needs a major victory in this round. And there's certainly one way to do that. That's to put his man down if he can. The man is more John. So at this point, as if he believes attack is the best form of defense. Ripping off the combinations, the Cuban in the red. Getting that evasive skill of Morjon, making Marton miss. Left hook from the Ukrainian doesn't find the target. And Andy Morjon is soaking up the time here now. Keeping his distance, using the ring. On into the last minute, knows it's now or never. And there's more John. Well, he's certainly not protecting his lead. He's feeling confident after the knockdown in the second round that he would be in front, but he's certainly not resting on his laurels. Marton getting a little loose and reckless, though, you would think. He looks tired as much as he still keeps coming forward. Morjon finishing strongly. Marton still throwing punches. Hoping against hope that one of them will put his opponent down. He's a fighter. They both are. That is the end of the fight. Third and final round. Jordan Alain, Hernandez Morjon of Cuba in the red. Looking set to take victory here over Robert Marton of the Ukraine in this men's heavyweight bout. These are the preliminary rounds, day one of the competition, under 91 kilograms weight category. Marton comes out to see who has won this fateful moment, and it is Hernandez Morjon of Cuba. Winner on points unanimously from all the judges. He took the third round 10-9. He dominated the fight, taking the points in every round. 30-27 from two judges, 26 from the second judge, and a convincing victory, unanimous on points for Jordan Alain Hernandez Morjon of Cuba. And there's the knockdown again. A couple of quick punches. Hernandez Morjon got him with the left and then uppercut with the right. He was already on his heels and that sent him to the canvas. Courageously, Marton kept coming. But Hernandez Morjon kept picking him off with that left hand. Good victory.
Welcome the referee and judges for men boxing 91 kilograms. 青年朋友们，女士们、先生们。
preliminary rounds of the men's heavyweight under 91 kilogram weight category. And next in the red corner, Michael Gallagher from Ireland. And in the blue, Maxim Kazlou from Belarus. The Irishman does a little jig, ready to climb into the ring. Maxim Kazlou.
The referee from People's Republic of China. Judges from Bulgaria. From Azerbaijan.
Edgard placed on Maxim Kazlou from Belarus. The referee for the next bout is from China, the host country of the Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games. The referee is Wang Meng. Both men turn nervous energy and adrenaline into action. And they don't size each other up. They don't cagily just keep their distance. They're immediately into it. In the red from Ireland, Michael Gallagher. And in the blue from Belarus, Maxim Kazlou. With the big uppercut punch. Not so much an uppercut, but an uppercut shape on it into the body. Big right hook missing from Gallagher. Straight right, firing through from Kazlou, missing the target. Gallagher goes after him with the left hook. Yeah, a little bit of a push upwards there with the glove, unnecessarily in the clinch from Kazlou. Ripping into the body from Gallagher. Does it again. Showing a liking for the right and left hook, Michael Gallagher. Kazlou gets the right over the top. Penetrated. Picks him off with a left jab as well, Kazlou. Left jab went straight between the gloves. There's that big wind-up right hand from Gallagher. Leading with the right, Michael Gallagher. Now he switches to orthodox. Straight right. Comes through from Kazlou. Take a break. Well, as it thunders one into the lower ribs. Some big body shots from Michael Gallagher. Gaslow, some very effective jabs, penetrating the defence. A little bit of blood from the nose of Michael Gallagher. It's been one of those jabs that did that damage. One jab through the forehead. Right, sneaky right hand as well from Caslow. Here's Gallagher. Thunderbolts from him. Caslow fighting back strongly. Suddenly putting Gallagher on the defensive. Gallagher decides he'll fight his way out of the spot as well. Three jabs in a row from Gallagher with that left. And the referees not all in agreement. Two of them favouring Gallagher, 10-9. One going the other way in favour of Caslow. Interesting that often enough the judges not all in agreement as to who has dominated a round, who finished the stronger or the better over the 3 minutes. As I say, they're contrasting styles of boxers, the alternating positions of the judges as well, and where they are viewing it from and which side of the ring. Why you have three judges rather than an even number. Both boxers varying their attack between the body and the head. Nico, a strong body shot. And Gallagher rips into the body with the left and then right cross over the top. Left jab from Caslow. Gallagher launching towards his opponent. Feints with the left. Left hook misses from Gallagher and takes some punishment to the head. Body shot from Gallagher. Just to make sure he keeps him above the belt. He has so far. Slow told not to pull his opponent across. And this time, the referee says to Gallagher, well, you're the one who's grabbing him. Right, over the top from Gallagher. See some fights which are dominated by jabs, but this is not one of them. Variety of punches, rips to the body, left and right hooks, occasional uppercut. And those rips to the body are going to take their toll. Gallagher's put plenty of shots through. Caslow, his share as well. And that is a tough second round. Michael Gallagher doing some damage to the body. Might slow Caslow down. In this third round, Caslow breathing heavily. Caslow with a short right, pummeling away at Gallagher, but Gallagher not easily hurt. Caslow again, driving over the top. Gets on, playing punches. Gallagher, who is in charge of the fight. Two of the judges scoring at 2018. Judge B has them even. But all judges giving the second round to Michael Gallagher. 10-9. So the third and final round begins. Bruising fight this. It'll be interesting to see in 2.5 minutes' time just who's got the legs. Just under 91 kilograms of weight behind these heavy punches. They're tenderizing the meat, you might say. Jab, jab, body shot from Gallagher. Left, right, body shot. He's hit the bag millions of times with that combination. Gallagher still going strong. Tasler got left in the tank. You hear the Irish camp. Come on, Michael. Go, Michael. Gallagher had the right cock for a long time and finally threw it from an awkward position. Didn't really have the shoulder behind it. It's becoming a scrap now. Two junkyard dogs going at it hard from close quarters. Just throwing whatever they've got left in their arms. That was a lovely sharp right from Gallagher. Still able to produce punch at speed and rips away to the body. That must have hurt. Kaslow. Michael Gallagher of Ireland in the red. And Maxim Kaslow of Belarus in the blue. Gallagher leading at the end of the second round. And Kaslow is running out of gas. Those body shots have taken their toll. His legs aren't moving the way they were earlier. He's still got weight in the punches. Gallagher gets turned around and the referee says keep your head up. He's been at Gallagher to make sure he stays front on a number of times. 40 seconds remaining. Gallagher keeps his distance this time. Kaslow steps forward. The Irish camp wanting Gallagher to finish this off strongly, and right now he looks like he's getting weary. Kaslow, what's he got left? They're both just about out on their feet. Gallagher rocks forward with the punch, goes over the top with that right hook. Both men just about done. They've thrown everything they've got at each other. Gallagher comes forward with a couple more. Kaslow throwing them. He's got nothing left in the arms, and he keeps on throwing them. And they stomp back to their corner. Lifting one leg after the other, but absolutely exhausted. They gave it everything. Maxim Kaslow from Belarus and this man, Michael Gallagher from Ireland, leaning on the ropes. Every bit of muscle and sinew aching. Here comes the decision. Gallagher thanks the camp from Belarus.
We won point by unanimous decision. The winner is a red corner representing Ireland.
Michael Gallagher still got energy for a victory celebration. Winner on points unanimously. He came through strongly there. His tactics of ripping away at the body of Kaslow certainly wore him down in the third round, and convincing victory. Two of the judges scoring at 30-27. Judge B more narrowly 29-28, but unanimous in favour of Michael Gallagher in the men's heavyweight division. Two big men. They were ready to rumble. left jab from Gallagher into the face. Another left jab, a short left to the face of Caslow. It wasn't a foregone conclusion, and you could see that from Gallagher's reaction, but it was a unanimous decision. Now the next bout that was scheduled featured from the USA, Barumni Rock, and from Argentina, Kevin Espendola. But Espendola did not show for a weigh-in, and so this will be a walkover for Barumni Rock of the USA. Rock making his way into the ring to claim the victory. Look at the size of this super heavyweight boxer, over 91 kilograms. He's ready to box, but as I say, we understand that Kevin Espendola from Argentina will not be able to take his place in the ring and did not weigh in, but it is still a requirement that Barumni Rock present himself in the ring, and the referee will confirm his victory without a punch in anger.
We by knock over. The winner is Red Corner, representing the United States of America.
So the Barumni Rock goes straight through to the semi-finals, winner by walkover. And well, that's the easy way to get yourself within range of a medal. Just six men in these weight divisions, and six women in the women's weight divisions as well. And so we go through the preliminaries, we're into the semi-finals. Barumni Rock go out the back and do a little bit of training instead of having a 3 minute by three round bout. Men's super heavyweight bout in the preliminary stage of competition. This is for boxers over 91 kilograms, open and above 91 kilograms. From Hungary, Laszlo Kamor in the red corner, and in the blue corner from Russia, Marat Keremkanov. Boxers are on their way. Hungarian. Look at the size of him. And, well, if size counts, and I'm sure it does, both the Russian and the Hungarian boxer here should put on a show. From Poland, Mariusz Gorny. these two big, powerful men, ready to rumble. Could be an audition for a movie, couldn't it, the size of them. But not just a question of size and power, it's also technique and most certainly stamina over three-minute rounds. Laszlo Komor from Hungary in the red. Marat Kerimkhanov of Russia in the blue. Hard to imagine that the lightest men's weight category is half this size. Imagine the damage that these powerful boxers would do if they're up against competitors from the men's light flyweight. That's if they could catch them, of course. That's the advantage of being a lower weight, speed, and evasive skills. But these men's super heavyweight built to deal out punishment. Very physical. Komor of Hungary in red. Kerimkhanov of Russia in blue. Stop. Box. In the clinch, breaking away themselves and with a couple of punches. There was a nice left jab there from Kerimkhanov. Komor working to the body. Combination of punches there from Komor. Aimed at the chin. Might not have quite found the target. Left hook on the break there from Kerimkhanov. Drew the referee's displeasure. Russian thuds a couple of right-handers into the abdomen region. And still he continues that attack. Laszlo Komor with the right hand thudding away at the body. Kerimkhanov with the gloves in good defensive position. Shielding a couple of blows coming from the left hand of Komor. Tight match between these two. Evenly contended through the first round. Kerimkhanov taking in the instructions of his coach. Russian coach. Listening carefully, you can see the signal there, jab jab to the rib area. And, that's an example of following the coach's instructions. And look at that right hook from Komor. How did the judges see it? And they saw it in favor of Kerimkhanov. Marat Kerimkhanov in the blue, getting the decision from the judges for round one, 10-9 from all three judges. Left-right combination from Komor. Right cross from Kerimkhanov. close to the mark. Big men lean in on each other. Combinations rattling, but off the gloves. Still Como working a few rips away at the body. Heavy breathing going on in there. Both in the clinch. Now Karamkhanov jabs his way out. Komor showing a greater variety of punches in this second round than in his first. Karamkhanov winning the first round. Hasn't, to my eyes, been as dominant so far in this round. Both are just slowing up a little now. A good jab from Karamkhanov. And another. Right cross on the left hook from Karamkhanov. Both missed. Looked good, but didn't score. Jab, jab. Left, right from Komor. Couldn't get past the gloves.
Stop.
Last few seconds of the second round. There's the bell. Karamkhanov starting to feel the effects of 6 minutes of action against Laszlo Komor. Komor seems to finish with a little more energy, not tiring as much in that second round. Komor still needing to take some deep breaths and cool down a little. There he is, look at those inhalations, exhalations. Trying to recover in the 1 minute break between rounds. Komor standing up, still ripping to the body.
Second round.
And the judges, well, Judge B and C favouring the boxing of Karamkhanov 2018. Judge A has it even. He gave the second round to Laszlo Komor. Komor may have even got the approval of two out of the three judges, but still Karamkhanov judged to be the superior boxer so far. But the way he finished that second round, Karamkhanov, he was really sucking them in and just looked as if he was weakening a little, as he did have to cop some heavy shots to the body in the first round from Komor. And whether or not that will eventually wear him down in this third round, we'll see how he finishes. Komor right now has a lot of work to do to win this fight. Men's super heavyweight, over 91 kilogram weight category, preliminary round bout. Komor has to land some good solid punches here. Karamkhanov boxing on. Karamkhanov wary. Stepped in and then stepped back. Jabs away on the break. Sharp jab from Karamkhanov. It's been one of his best weapons. Feints to throw the left. Right cross instead. from Terence Carnot. Comor not quite finding his range either. He's trying to tag his opponent, but he can't quite get there. Terence Carnot, a slight advantage in reach, and using it to his advantage right now. It's 49 seconds, and it's going to be a long 49. It's going to feel like 5 minutes as the lactic acid builds up. Oxygen short. Comor goes after Kerem Karnov. So the Russian in the blue, the Hungarian in the red. It's the man in red. He needs to finish strongly, but they're both getting weary now. I think Comor's just about punched himself out as well. Comor knows that he's got to throw a few more, and he can just land a big one on the chin, and it'll be exactly what's required. And the bell goes to finish the third and final round. Balance of the three judges at the end of the second round favouring Marat Keremkanov of Russia in the blue. Comor gave it his very best. So whether that was enough to close the margin down in the judges' view, we will soon know. The etiquette for boxing to thank the opponent's camp, and here comes the decision. Referee will struggle to lift the arms of these 91-kilogram super heavyweights.
We conclude by unanimous decision. The winner is blue corner, representing Russian Federation.
In the blue corner, Marat Keremkanov of Russia. A winner on points. Unanimous decision from the judges. All the judges giving the last round to Marat Keremkanov to consolidate his performance in the first two rounds. And final score then, Judge B and C, 30-27, Keremkanov. Judge A to Keremkanov, 29-28 by the 1 point margin. The judges from Greece, Sri Lanka and Great Britain. And a couple of highlights from this bout as these two big men sorted it out between them. Marat Keremkanov has his arm raised in victory, and the Russian will go through to the next phase, the semi-final stage of the men's super heavyweights. Seen some great action in the men's light flyweight, men's bantamweight, men's light welterweight, middleweight and heavyweight and super heavyweight in this session. Right through those men's categories, let's see some of the action.